In this video, we're going to look at odds and probability. We're going to look at the definition of odds, how to convert a probability into odds, how to convert odds into a probability, and a look at why odds are often confused with probability. First, let's look at the definition of odds. Odds are equal to the number of favorable outcomes divided by the number of unfavorable outcomes, and we usually write that result as a ratio as opposed to writing it as a fraction. Let's look at an example. What are the odds of drawing an ace from a deck of 52 cards? Well, using the definition, we have four favorable outcomes because there's four aces in a deck of cards, and that leaves 48 cards that are not aces, so we have 48 unfavorable outcomes. So our odds are equal to the ratio 4 over 48. But we write this as a ratio. We have the ratio 4 to 48, or we might write that as 4 to 48, like this, in favor of drawing an ace. Now we can reduce those ratios. We can divide 4 by 4 and 48 by 4 and get a ratio 1 to 12, or write that as 1 to 12 odds in favor of drawing an ace. We can also define odds in the following way. Odds equals the probability of a favorable outcome divided by the probability of an unfavorable outcome. In the previous problem, the probability of the favorable outcome was 4 out of 52 because there's 4 aces in a deck of 52. So we have 4 52nds in the numerator. The probability of the unfavorable outcome was 48 out of 52 because there's 48 cards that are not an ace. So we get 4 52nds divided by 48 52nds. To divide by that bottom fraction, we invert 48 52nds and multiply by 52 over 48. So we have 4 over 52 times 52 over 48. The two factors of 52 cancel, and we end up with 4 to 48 as our ratio, which again simplifies to 1 to 12 in favor. Now let's look at a problem or two where we convert a probability into odds. For example, there's a 45% chance of rain. That's our probability. What are the odds in favor of rain? Well, since the chance of rain is 45%, we can write that as 0.45. So that means we have a probability of no rain being 55% or 0.55. Now we can use that second definition for odds, the probability of the favorable event divided by the probability of the unfavorable event. So we get odds equals 0.45 divided by 0.55, which is 45 over 55 if we multiply the numerator and the denominator by 100, and 45 over 55 simplifies to 9/11. So odds in favor of rain are 9 to 11. In the next example, we have a probability of winning a prize being 0.005. What are the odds in favor of winning this prize? Well, since the probability in favor of winning is 0.005, the probability of not winning is going to be 1 minus 0.005, which is 0.995. Remember, you can always do this to find the probability of the event not happening. Just subtract the probability from 1. So we get odds of 0.005 to 0.995. Now, I don't like those decimal odds. So what you can do here is divide each of those numbers by the same number. If you divide 0.005 by 0.005, you get 1. And if you divide 0.995 by 0.005 on your calculator, you will get 199. So the odds in favor of winning are 1 to 199. And I have a note here. 0.995 would be known as the probability of the complement. So you get the complement by subtracting the probability from 1. Now let's look at converting odds to a probability. And I have an example. The odds in favor of the Minnesota Vikings winning a game are given as 2.8 to 1. What is the probability of the Vikings winning the game? Well, let's start by putting those numbers into a ratio using our definition of odds. 2.8 to 1 odds in favor means there are 2.8 favorable events for every one unfavorable event. This is 2.8 favorable events over one unfavorable event, as shown here. Now, I don't like those decimals in my ratio, so I'm going to multiply top and bottom by 10, and that gives me a ratio of 28 favorable events over 10 unfavorable events. Well, if there's 28 favorable events and 10 unfavorable, that makes a total of 38 events. So I get a probability of 28 favorable events divided by 38 total possible events. That gives me my probability of 28 38ths, which if I divide it out, we get 0.737 rounded off to three places, which is a 73.7 chance that they will win the game. Or one of the things I want to deal with is why odds are confused with probability. Oftentimes people are talking about odds when they're really meaning probability, and vice versa. Why is this? Well, for small probabilities, odds and probabilities are nearly equal. In that previous problem, we had a probability of 0.005, and we ended up with odds of 1 to 199. But if you divide out 1 divided by 199, you get 0.005025, and it repeats a ways. But that's very close to 0.005. And also 0.005 is 5 one-thousandths, which is 1 over 200. That's very close to 1 over 199. So you might think, well, they're practically the same. Why not use them interchangeably all the time? When you have probabilities that are not so small, then odds and probabilities are quite different from each other. For example, odds of 3 to 4 in favor are going to be equal to a probability of 3 to 7, because the 3 favorable added to the 4 unfavorable events makes a total of 7 events. 3/4 is 0.75, but 3/7 is less than 50%. They're quite a bit different. In the gaming industry, however, odds are used because the general public is more familiar with the term odds than probabilities. You know, perhaps someone has done some marketing study that said these games will sell better if we use odds rather than probabilities. And often, probabilities for a game of chance will be listed as approximate odds when actually they are probabilities. I have some actual examples of this in your homework coming up. For very small probabilities, like 1 out of 1,000 chance of winning, the associated odds are 1 to 999 in favor. They're nearly equal. So for the small probabilities, it works to use the odds. And provided they use the words approximate odds, I guess they're not fooling anyone. But keep in mind that oftentimes when they say odds, they really mean probabilities. And they are not the same, as the middle example in red shows. They can be quite different from each other.